We now complete our discussion of unitary matrices by pointing out that they not only have nice theoretical properties, but they actually have nice computational properties as well. Where does that come from? Well, at the end of week one, we looked at the conditioning of solving linear systems. And we showed that a relative error in the right-hand side is at most amplified by the condition number of A into a relative error in the solution. And you know, that gave us an idea of how bad things could get, how error could be amplified. Now, you can do the exact same thing when you do y equal to A times x. And what you're going to see in a homework for this unit is that the relative error in x that goes in is at most amplified by the condition number of A into a relative error in y. And again, the condition number of an arbitrary matrix A could be pretty bad. If A is almost singular, then it would be bad. Now, as the course goes on, we're going to see a lot of algorithms that have the property that you apply a bunch of matrices to a vector or to a matrix in an effort to transform those matrices into something nicer. Now, every time you multiply by a matrix, you have the potential of amplifying relative error. That's bad. What if we restricted ourselves to matrices that have a condition number equal to 1? Then the relative error would never be amplified. Well, it turns out that if you choose your norm to be the 2 norm, and you only employ unitary matrices, unitary matrices have a condition number equal to 1 when you use the 2 norm. And as a result, if in your algorithms you only apply unitary matrices in your effort to transform the problem into a nicer problem, you won't amplify error, relative error. And that's why unitary matrices are our tool of choice.